Welcome to Sports Talk.
Hello everyone, welcome. I'm Nick from Top Notch Sports, and today we're going to be going over my 2021 final rankings. This is it, ladies and gentlemen. This is my final rankings, and we're going to do a little bit of a fun video here today showing you who I got ranked, who's going to go higher than expected, and who I think will go lower than expected, who should be sleepers, who is fool's gold. And the way we'll figure that out today is my grading scale. You're going to see my before rankings, my new rankings, my final grading, ranking scales, I guess you can say, how I order these guys. Again, one thing I want to point out right away is that the order that I put these guys in, again, it can really change depending on what team they go to. I want to make that very apparent right now. But number one thing is red equals fool's gold. If you see a guy's name in red on the final ranking scale, that means that I feel like they're fool's gold. That means that they're getting a little bit overhyped and they might get drafted a little bit too early. Now, again, it's hard to say depending on where they'll get drafted tonight, but from the media, from what I've been hearing, a few of these guys I feel like are fool's gold. And the green guys are my sleepers. These are guys that I truly think that might fall down boards that are going to be really, really good. So these are the guys that I think that are going to get drafted too early. These are the guys that I think that are going to get drafted a little bit later. Now, again, by that, just because they're drafted early does not mean that I don't think they'll be good. It just means that I feel like they're getting overdrafted, okay? Based on their talent compared to where they're getting drafted. Green means I feel like they're getting drafted later in rounds where I feel like these guys are really going to be better than what the media is saying they are. So let's hop right into it. Let's start with the quarterbacks. And this was my 1.0 ranking. This is what you saw on the video. It was Lawrence 1, Wilson 2, Jones 3, Mon 4, Fields 5, and Lance 6. Let's go to my 2.0. And here you go, my quarterback. This is it. This is a finale. I do got Wilson as a better prospect. Now, what does that mean? That does not mean that Trevor Lawrence is not should not go number one, okay? Trevor Lawrence is most likely, and I would put $100,000 on that Trevor Lawrence is going to go number one. But I still feel like Zach Wilson is just more talented than Trevor Lawrence. So from a prospect point of view, I do have Wilson going to my number one spot in my final rankings. Lawrence 2, Jones 3, Mon 4, Lance 5, Fields 6, Mills 7, Trask 8, Newman 9, Purdy 10. Now, again, what does this mean? Well, I feel like Mac Jones is going to get drafted, whether it's 3, whether it's 8, whether it's 10, 15, 20. I don't care. I feel like this guy deserves to be a top 3 quarterback. And again, I got him 3rd on my ranking scale, but I feel like he's being slept on a little bit by the media saying that he shouldn't go, that Lance and Fields should go. I feel like he's somebody that's getting a little bit slept on. I promise you, this kid's going to be good. Kellen Mond's another one. I truly feel like this guy's first round talent ran all over him. He might fall to the 2nd, 3rd round, maybe late 1st tonight. We'll have to wait and see. But the two guys that are getting really overhyped that I feel like there's a lot of problems with, not so much Lance. Lance, I feel like now I do have him ranked over Fields. I did have Fields over him. I do like what I see from Lance a little bit better on film. He does have a little bit better of an arm. I feel like he goes through some progressions better and quicker. He makes his decisions a lot faster, runs a pro-ready offense. Fields, on the other hand, just doesn't do all that. He has a natural ability of his legs. So does Lance. He has a great arm. So does Lance. But he likes to run first. And my hot take on running quarterbacks in college is if you're going to run in college, you rely on it a little bit too much. So when you get to the NFL, you don't throw as much. Okay. So Fields is much more of a one guy, and then he either looks at his 2nd guy and doesn't pull the trigger and takes off and runs, or he just decides to run after the first option is not available. Next guy is Davis Mills. I feel like this guy is definitely a little bit of a sleeper. Team will probably get him in the 2nd, 3rd round, and it'll be pretty dang good. I like what I saw. Kyle Trask is 8, Newman 9, Purdy's 10. Let's go to running backs. Here's my 1.0. You're more than welcome to look at this. Let's get to the 2.0. Here we go. Some movers here. And again, top 3 guys. This does not mean I don't like the top 3 guys. This means that I feel like Najee Harris is the best guy. Etienne's the 2nd best and Williams is the 3rd best. But there are some sleepers here. And I do got some movement going on from like 4 to 7 here a little bit. So when you go back here, you see Hill is up here. You see Evans is up here. And you see people like Hubbard and Stevenson are way down here. Well, now on the new rankings, I got Stevenson and Hubbard moving up a little bit on my scale. So again, I got Harris 1, Etienne 2, Williams 3. Elijah Mitchell is one of my sleepers. I feel like this kid could be really solid. Same thing with Javion Hawkins, Jarrett Patterson, and Ramondre Stevenson. Hubbard going 8, Hill going 9, Evans going 10, right? And you can go right down the list. You can look at that as much as you want. Listen, again, I want to point out something right here, and I'll point it out again at the end of the video, that 9 out of 10 times, these guys that are highlighted are not going to pan out. I'm going to be honest with you guys. there's when you look at a draft, all right, you got the five top quarterbacks. Let's go all the way back to their quarterbacks here. It would not shock me if only two to three of these guys in the entire draft pan out. And that's what you usually see. Think about going back to like the 2014 NFL draft, Bridgewater, Bortles, Carr, right? All those guys. How many of them have really been starting quarterbacks their entire career? And the only one I can name is Derek Carr. Derek Carr is the only guy. Go to 2015, right? I'm pretty sure that was a Mariota and Winston year. Where are they? Yeah, that's right. One of them might be a starter, right? 2016 was the Wentz-Goff year, okay? How many of them are starters? Well, we got Wentz who got to a second team now and Goff on a second team now. Neither of them really panned out the way they were supposed to. So we didn't go straight down the line, keep going on and on. Trubisky, right? And Darnold, okay? And again, it depends on the circumstances that these players go to. And not only the circumstance, but that usually a lot of these guys don't pan out. So again, just because they're green, I mean, I would be happy if I got one of these four guys were actually turned out to be okay. It's hard to predict that thing. But all in all, I feel like those are the guys that have a potential of being good. And these are my guys. When I scouted them, I discovered these guys, and I'm happy I did because I like these guys a lot. Let's go to our next guy, wide receivers. Here is my 1.0. You're more than welcome to look at it. Here's my 2.0. Not a lot of movement going on. A few guys moving down. Amir Smith-Marset's moving down. Dwayne Eskridge moving up a little bit. Terrace Marshall moving up a little bit. But again, ultimately, I want to point out this. Teylon Wallace is a huge sleeper, in my opinion. Rashad Bateman's a huge sleeper, in my opinion. Ja'Marr Chase, I feel like, is getting a little bit overhyped for what he did. Dyami Brown's a little bit somebody that's getting a little bit slept on. Same thing with Kadarius Toney and Simi Fehoko. Okay, so there you go. Another guy that's getting a little bit overhyped is Amon-Ra St. Brown. We'll see where he goes. Again, this is my ranking. If he gets drafted 22nd or he goes to a scheme fit, he might pan out. Same thing with Chase. I'm not saying Chase is a bad player, but to be the first receiver off the board is a little bit crazy. Now, again, if he goes with Joe Burrow and he pairs up with his old LSU buddy, he might pan out because they got chemistry. They're going to a system where they're familiar with all that stuff. But all in all, I don't feel like he should be the first receiver taken off the board. Here's the next guy, the tight end, and this is the same. I didn't move any of my tight ends. From here on out, all my rankings honestly stayed the same, but you see someone that I'm saying right now, here's my one sleeper in Tommy Tremble. I feel like this guy to turn out to be really, really solid. Interior offensive lineman, you know, look at it again, hit pause if you want to. Landon Dickerson's a guy that I feel like people are saying, oh, yeah, he's going to fall down boards. He's going to fall a little bit. He might fall to the second round, mid-second, late second. No, this guy is a guy that you should trade up for. He's the best center in the league and in the draft, and I feel like he'll be an absolute stud. Again, Elijah Vera Tucker is my number one interior offensive lineman. And Deontay Brown, I feel like, is definitely being overhyped. You go to offensive tackles, and here we go again. Sewell, Slater, I love Slater, but two's proper. That's where he should go. And everyone's hyping him up just the way he should be. Liam Eichenberg is somebody, and Dylan Raduns is somebody that I really feel like these two tackles should really be considered early. And Christian Darsol is somebody that I feel like is definitely being overhyped by the media. We go to defensive tackles. Davion Nixon is someone that should definitely be looked at higher for people's skill. I got him ranked as my number one. You look at Barmore, he's my number three. I feel like he's been a little bit overhyped. I know that he's supposed to be the four-shore one. His run defense is not the greatest. And Tyler Shelvin, I watched more film on him lately. This guy's a pure run stuffer. I'll be honest with you. I love what I see from Tyler Shelvin. Here's Edge. Ronnie Perkins is my number one guy. I feel like this guy's being slept on a lot. Again, if he goes anywhere in the top, I would say even six, I would be happy with that. But this guy should not be slept on too much. I like Phillips. I like Osai. I like Pay. I like Russo. I like Roche. Okay, I like all those guys. But then there's one guy that I feel like has been a little bit overhyped, and I got him all the way down here, and that's Azeez Ojulari. And again, it's not meaning that he's not going to be good. I just got him ranked as my 11th ranked edge rusher. You know, to my linebackers, here we go, Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah. Huge fan of this kid. Absolute huge fan of this kid. Definitely should not be slept on. I like Zaven Collins as well. But again, I feel like the order after that's fine. I just feel like he's being slept on a little bit. And I feel like he should be the number one linebacker taken off the board. Although Micah Parsons is more versatile than he is. So I understand why Parsons would be the first guy off the board. Cornerbacks, here we go. I got a lot of guys I love here. A lot of guys I love. The top three is the top three, all right? That's however it is. You didn't tell me you like Surtain, you like Farley. I think Farley would be ranked a lot higher. He would probably be my number one guy if it wasn't for his injuries. You got to put that and question those concerns. But you look at these guys here, Eric Stokes, Marco Wilson, and Sean Wade. And these three guys right here, I have high, high hopes for, all being really slept on by the media. Greg Newsome, I think, should be seven. Never finished a college season before. I feel like that's proper. And my other two guys I really think are sleepers are Kelvin Joseph and Paulson Adebo. When I watched film on all five of those guys, I fell in love with these guys. I feel like they should go a lot higher than what the media is saying they should be. And it's names to keep an eye out for. And last but not least, my safety position. Here we go. Trevon Moehrig, Holland, Sitzko. But then my two guys here, Jamar Johnson and Kadon Stearns. These two guys are something special in my opinion. Jamar Johnson is a really great cover safety that should be looked at later in the draft for sure. Maybe third, fourth round, right, might get drafted. And Kadon Stearns, man, had the best pro day out of all these guys. Pretty sure he had like a 42, 43-inch vertical and ran a 4.4, 140. This guy, even on film, he popped a little bit. Those two guys are people that a lot of people are sleeping on. You might see people like Washington and even Grant get drafted before these two, but I truly feel like Johnson and Stearns deserve to be higher. So, guys, that's all. That's this video. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed. I got my mock drafts coming. I'm going to do what I think for one round mock draft of what I think is going to happen in the first round. And then I'm going to do what I would do for three rounds and a three round mock draft coming very shortly. So, stay tuned. Be sure to leave a like, subscribe. We'll see you guys soon. Peace. We are Built Better.